Shalom lekulam. Danny asked me to demonstrate how to teach in flipped classroom. So I started actually teaching in this way about 13 years ago. So what I did, a series of relatively short videos. Many of them I filmed in my office. And I show you an example of such a video now.
Hello. Today we will talk about easy way to differentiate complicated vector matrix functions. In particular, we will show how to compute easily Jacobian gradient and Hessian of matrix vector expressions. Let us start with the notion of Jacobian. Suppose we have a vector function of a vector variable. So we have a vector x in Rn, and we have a function with components f1 of x, f2 of x, and so on, fm of x.
So this video was filmed with usual smartphone. I placed it rather close, as you see, to the whiteboard, maybe 1 meter from the whiteboard or a little bit more. And as you see, the quality is pretty good. So students watch those videos at home and come to class for discussions and problem solvings. And last years with coronavirus, so I continued to do the same via Zoom. So students watch at home pre-recorded videos like you see now, and then in class we have an interactive Zoom session, which I will try to show you next. So here you start watching my Zoom recording, and often I start my Zoom lectures with a quiz to make sure that students watch lectures properly at home. And then they may submit those quizzes via Moodle system, for example.
I hope, yes, I see my recording is working. So, good morning to everybody. And as usual, here is our quiz. Prove a Minimax theorem in the way it was done in the lecture. And you can start working.
And after the quiz, after students submit the quiz, it usually takes about 5 minutes, or maybe a little bit more. I continue with overview of the lecture they watched, and then we start to discuss and solve problems.
With the backup recording, yes, and one more. Okay, so, well, I see that only me is recording now. Okay, so our lecture today is about Minimax. Well, just a second, hand tool. Okay, about Minimax games and Lagrangian duality. It's very interesting. We are coming to really hardcore of optimization. This topic is usually challenging, but I hope that I succeed to bring it in a relatively simple way. So the first thing you already learned and showed that if I have a function of two vector variables, then just let me see. Yes. Then if I minim so I should I minimize in Z and maximize in omega, but I compare different order, which one I do first. It is unusual a little bit. What is on the right-hand side, what is inside the parentheses, you do first. You first minimize in Z, and then maximize in omega. And what we learned, how I try to memorize, if I do the operation first, it works, it has a stronger consequence. If I minimize in Z, the result will remain smaller than all other results. So max min is smaller than or equal than and what we learned, how I try to memorize, if I do the operation first, it works, it has a stronger consequence. If I minimize in Z, the result will remain smaller than all other results. So max min is smaller than or equal than min max. Any question, any comment for this very, very central statement? Yes.
Yes, I have a question.
Yes.
In the video, the right-hand side, you denote it as a constant at some point, and the left-hand side, you say, like at one point you say the minimum of Z would probably would be bigger than the const, and that I didn't quite.
Okay, so you invite me to come to the ideas of proof. I don't have proof on my slides, but to make it clear for the listeners, okay, what is the sketch of the proof? First says that if we minimize in Z, we remove Z from the consideration. We leave only with function of omega. And then, of course, this function of omega will be less or equal than the same function for arbitrary Z and given omega. And now the second part. After I maximize it in omega, I'm left with number. You're right. I'm left with number. And then, so if all this expression is smaller or equal to this expression in parentheses, then this number will be smaller or equal. Then this function, expression in parentheses, is function of Z. Then for any given Z, this will be greater or equal than this number. I'm not sure that I'm very clear. If I do minimization, I remain with function of omega. After I do maximization in omega, I leave this number. And try again to formulate your question now.
And that's, I got that part, that you have on the right-hand side a number. In the video, you say this number has to be smaller than max omega on the left-hand side, FZW.
Yes.
And then you say, if I minimize Z, then it's also true.
What is written here in parentheses, this is a function of Z.
Right.
I say that my function of Z is larger than some number. I should plus something. I have function of Z, some function, okay? And this function is larger than some number C.
Why did you put the C over there and not a little bit higher?
Because it's larger for any Z. If I would put it here, then there will be some Z.
Okay.
It is not larger. Okay.
I got it. Thank you.
Okay. Good. Okay. Let's continue.
I have also a question.
And it's very good that you have become active. This is very challenging stuff. And getting through proof. Okay. What is the second question?
So in the video, you said the word states that you took the maximum of the omega, right?
Okay. You should say, what should I show in the slide?
Okay. You see what I'm doing here?
Just a second. How can I see? You mean your video?
You see what I'm writing on your
okay. Yes. Very good. Yes.
So there was a stage where you said if the omega like this is greater than minimum over Z, if the omega.
Okay.
I have a question.
So the claim is that this statement is true for any given Z.
Yes.
For any given Z, if I fix any given Z, so I remain on the left as a function on omega and on the right as a function of omega.
Yes. I have a question about it. So.
Okay.
When you have a function from both sides of the inequality, functions of omega.
Yes.
You mean that every omega you plug the same omega in the two sides, the same omega you plug in the same side? Or
I think I know your question. Let me do some illustration. So we have a function of omega. Yes. I have one function of omega, and I have it may even have some minimum. Yes. Let's do it more. It may have some minimum. And I have other function of omega, which also might have some minimum even in other place. Yes? Let me take better pen. Is this pen good enough? Yes. Okay. And the claim we have, what claim do we have? Say that this is F1 and this is F2. If for every omega one function is smaller than other, then my claim is that also the minimum will be smaller than this minimum. It may be indifference. Yes?
Okay.
Did I answer your question?
I need to think about it. Because what I wanted to see, if you would tell me FZ omega card and DRZ omega time, which are variables that can...
To understand this formula. But this, from graph, you understand. Then if this function is larger than this, then there cannot be a situation that minimum of this function is smaller than this minimum, because otherwise it should go, if minimum would be smaller than this, yes, it should intersect somehow. It should have some area where it's smaller than F1.
Okay.
Okay, I hope I answered your question.
Thank you.
Okay. So, and now we can continue to this next. Just a second. Okay. And then we have a game interpretation, which is very important. It opens you another view. So we say we have two players, Z player and one of them. Game. Why? Because F, I didn't tell you that F is only positive. F may have a positive and negative value. But there may be an area where F is negative. So it's normal game. And because it is formulated that Z is paying this amount to omega, so naturally it wants to minimize the amount, and omega wants to maximize. And what happens?
Now I skip a little bit more explanations and discussion in class, and we come to solving class problems.
A table with such values, a matrix with values 1, 2, 3, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And I say that I have two variables. I have z variables, which is index in this direction. And I have omega variable, which is index in this direction. So omega may take value of 1, 2, 3, and that belongs to 1, 2, 3. So that says which index I will choose in this direction. Omega says which index I will choose in this direction. And those are function values. And our task now is to find the min, max, and max min of this function. And how can we proceed? We should, let me see where it's better to write. We should minimize in Z and maximize in omega. I will put it in this way, F. This is my matrix F. I will even put capital F. And Z omega will be two indexes. Z omega will be two indexes. So Z is index 1, 2, 3, and omega is index 1, 2, 3. And what I will do, I will do the following auxiliary task. I want to minimize in Z. Let the fix omega. Omega will say which row I use. And Z will say which column I use. Let fix omega and say what will be minimum of FZ omega when omega is 1. What will be minimum in this first row? We should minimize in this direction we minimize, and in this direction we maximize.
So and here I post a problem, and now student will show the solutions.
Looking for a volunteer to show it.
Michal, I can show.
Okay, please, I stop my sharing. Stop share. Okay, and you can share the screen.
Just a moment. Here.
Okay, good. You didn't fill the values. It was not easy for you. Ah, okay.
Yes.
You put it in writing here. Okay, so you did it in writing. And, okay, so you got min, max, and max min the same?
Yes, I think so.
Maybe okay, did anybody get it different?
Yeah, I got the min, max is greater than the...
Okay. Let's...
I stopped sharing.
Yes, okay. Because this was a special example without saddle point, and inequality should be strict.
It depends on what axis you define as
saddle. Okay, let's look on example. It's much easier to look on example and then discuss the result. So who is sharing? Okay.
Can you see my screen?
It starts its sharing, but not entirely yet.
This is one.
Not yet.
Okay. It is okay now. Okay. So, okay, please comment what you did.
Okay, so here is the table, 3, 8, 7, 4, 2, 9, 5, 1, 6.
Okay.
When I want to minimize over the row, I take, for each row, its minimal value. So for the first row, the minimal value is 3. For the second row, the minimal value is 2. And for the third row, the minimal value is 1. Mm-hmm. I put it here.
Yes.
So I do...
Okay, I stopped video at this point, and I hope you got an impression how it's possible to do an interactive flipped classroom over Zoom. Thank you for watching.